bonise. Ah, bonise.
Alright, this topic is about to proper stress me out. Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. As you can see in the video down below, we are about to get real, okay? We're about to get so real because I am like I am 5'2 being so upset with regards to this that I just thought that I should do a topic and a real talk topic, and we're gonna get into it. I even got my notes down and everything. I'm just like, yes, get all life, go get all life. So, if you'd like to watch this video, then please keep watching, okay? One thing that I do have to say is that I might go off at a tangent in this video purely because I'm very passionate about this topic, and it's actually like back here to pissing me off, and I feel like I need to talk about it. So let's talk about being single. Let's talk about the stereotypes that are associated with being a single woman around the bracket of 25, 30. We're looking at that, right? As you can see, the color of my skin, I am black. So when you are black and you grow up with aunties and uncles and all these people that are in your family, normally it's family. Really, honestly, it's family, because ain't nobody who's outside your family that's gonna try you with a topic like this, okay? So normally it's family members. Yes, I am single. As you can see, I'm not married, and that's by choice. It's fine. But I'm 30 as well. So I get a lot of comments that are addressed to me, especially by family members, talking about, ooh, girl, why are you single? Ooh, girl, where's your boo? Ooh, girl, where's... And not even in those terms. Like, ooh, Katleho, motho wa hao o kae? Like, family events. Motho wa hao o kae? Hao, Katleho, hao na ngwana? It is a little bit of... there are a bunch of stereotypes when it comes to being single and black and a female and 30. Now, no one will ever ask a man at 30, why are you single? But chances are, as a woman, you get asked over 100 million, 50,000 trillion times that, oh, why are you single? And there's a lot of stereotypes that are associated with why a woman of 30 years old is single. Let me tell you, in the black community, right? They're gonna sit here and say, one, she can't keep a man. Girl, you should be worried that men can't even keep up with me, chaba. I'm being serious, okay? I'm being serious. Like, oh, she can't keep a man. I can't keep a man. Okay, she's single. She's 30. She doesn't have any kids. Maybe she can't have them. So you are present in my uterus and in all this facets of my life, fallopian tubes and all that, to know that I can't conceive, really? So this is a common stereotype, especially in this country, where I've noticed ever since being on the other side of 25, I get asked a lot of questions by aunts, uncles, at family events and things like that, that, oh, why don't we see your, you know, your man, blah, 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 or, you know, Katleho, you're 30 and you don't have a child. You should really consider having a child. And you know what? It's okay. You don't have to be married to want to have a child. You can have a child. You work well. You can financially support yourself. You're stable. You should consider having a child because biological clock. Ooh, I don't understand why people just can't consider the fact that maybe you choose to be single, maybe you choose to not be married, but okay, but it's fine, we're going to talk about it. So, one of the big stereotypes is, she can't keep a man. Where? Like, at which point must even, like, why the whole notion of you know, these things not happening or being said about men, but being said about women is what disturbs me the most. You'll never hear someone say that, oh, this man can't keep a woman, that's why he is single and he's 30 and whatever, whatever. You'll never hear it, but you will always, always, like, bet your bottom dollar that you will always, always, always hear someone say, oh, no, she probably can't keep a man or whatever, blah, 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 blah. There's no such rubbish in life, okay? If you are single, remember, you choose to be single. If you want to be single, especially as women, we have got a pocketbook of a long list of men who want to just hit you up, take you out for coffee, date you, be with you. We have a long list. It's like a waiting list. If you are a woman and you've got, basically, there will be somebody trying to get with you. Okay, and then the second thing that I get is, oh, you're too intimidating. And I get this a lot from men themselves. Abo brother, they're going to tell you that, oh, you're too intimidating. What is too intimidating? What is it? Is me being sure of myself too intimidating? Is me being able to take care of myself financially, emotionally, and otherwise too intimidating? Is me being sure of who I am, where I come from, where I'm going, where I've been too intimidating? I just don't understand how these aren't things that aren't seen as more inspiring and motivating, and instead are seen as a negative. You're too intimidating. Then if I'm too intimidating for you, then you're not the person I'm looking for to begin with. You'll have these relatives who'll talk like, you know, sometimes you need to understand that with a man, you need to be submissive. There's certain things you can't say, especially in the black, okay? In the black race, there's certain things you can't say. Mind the things you do, the way you dress, blah, blah, blah. I still got an auntie who tells me this, and I love her to death, but every single time she starts going on about the men's, I'm just like, because I just don't understand why I need to be any other form of myself than what I am, which is sure of myself and confident and independent and this and this and that and the other, to now dumb that down for the sake of a man. Where? Okay. And then the other thing is, I love this one. You're too independent. I'm sorry. So the fact that I can take care of myself is too independent and it's a problem. The fact that I pay my bills adequately on time. I can travel if I want to travel with my moonies. I can do whatever it is I want. That is now supposed to be seen as a negative when it comes to scoring a partner. Goopila. I mean, what I'm trying to understand is that it's the 21st century. At which point is too independent a problem? Hell, you need to be independent. At which point should we now have to so heavily rely on a man to get by or to score one or to whatever, that you can't even support yourself? At which point? It is 20 motherfucking 18. I don't get why me having achieved so much, too independent, you, and the irony of this is when you get scored in terms of lobola, when they're sitting there and having a meeting, when you get scored, they look at your independence as a plus. They look at the fact that you don't have a kid as a plus. But when it comes to the dating scene and you being single, your independence is now all of a sudden being seen as something that inhibits you from possibly getting married. At which point should these things be seen as things that will invalidate me when it comes to a man or scoring a husband? Hooray! One thing that will be said of you, they might not say it to your face, but one thing that will be said of you is that you can't conceive. Last I checked, this area of my body was perfectly fine. I don't understand how this person from the outside seems to think that maybe I can't conceive and maybe that's why I can't seem to land a man. Where? Girl! Or land a husband, sorry. Landing a man is easy. Landing a husband is a little bit tricky. Well, it's always the people from outside. It's always the people from outside who will come up to you and say all these ridiculous things like, oh, maybe you're too intimidating. Your independence is just too much. Maybe she's not able to conceive. Why are these things seen as things that will inhibit you from getting a husband? What if you don't want one? When are you getting married? When am I getting... That's the one question that I get a lot. When are you getting married? When I do, I'll be sure to let you know. When I do. But I don't see why you are concerned with this part. Of- I just don't get why these things aren't things that aren't being asked to men. But are being... People feel so comfortable and confident to get up in your face and ask you such ridiculous questions. First and foremost, what if somebody chooses to be single? What if somebody chooses not to have children? Which is a thought that has crossed my mind. It's still filtering around in there somewhere that maybe I just love other people's kids, okay? Maybe I just feel like I don't want my own. Why is that comment alone going to be seen as, girl, no, you can't say that. Why not? If you are listening to this and you are single, and you choose to be single, there is absolutely nothing wrong with being single and choosing to be single, girl. Live your best life. Go out on multiple dates. Do this, do that. Yenze zinto ezisiras that make for the pots to be done to satisfy yourself. Girl, it does not matter. It shouldn't matter. None of these things should validate any form of getting into a relationship or a marriage with anyone. So if I'm married at 30, will I have achieved something? I don't know. Maybe for me, I see having a home and having like cars fill up my garage because I love cars, okay? Being able to travel the world as and when I want, first class, and doing this and this and that and the other. Maybe that's what I see as something that will validate my life. Not a man or marriage. You should never, ever, ever, ever feel pressured into feeling like those are the things that you should do in your life purely from other people that will validate your life. Absolutely not. Forget it. I don't know. This video is already 17 minutes long, so I am gonna go. What are your thoughts about this? What have you heard from other people or family members or whatever pertaining to you being single or being, you know, just living your best life? Katleho, a ring. You're rubbish, Leon. That's it for me. If you would like to see more videos like this, some of the things that I come across being my age and single, then let me know and I'll definitely get back to you on those and maybe doing those for you. Until the next one, I'll see you very, very soon. Bye. If I single, live your best life when I girl.